Welcome to the presentation of my new editor tool for Unity called Anim3D Dodudi. So if you ever wanted to have a convenient and easy workflow to convert a 3D animation into a 2D animation and then export this as separate image set or as sprite sheet, then this is the asset for you. So and in this video I will quickly guide you through the steps and show you what is possible with the asset. So first we will call the asset window by clicking here on Anim3D to 2D and on the animation recorder. So this is the main window in which everything takes place. First we need to have some setup. To record our animations we need to have a camera in place. I can just assign the main camera by clicking on assign main camera. And then we also need an object that will be recorded. This object serves as relative center point to the camera, so that the asset knows where it has to focus. And for this I have this little elf right here. Isn't it lovely? Okay, let's assign this. In this point in time, the asset also needs an animator component. Later this will not be necessary anymore, as it should also work with a particle system or animation clip or just any game object and you can make your still image. So next we will select our animation and I just say running in panic because that's what this little guy will do in the game. And then I can preview the animation. I enable the preview and then also the animation preview. And I can see what it looks like. Okay. But I have no idea how it will look like in the final version when we have converted this animation to a 2D animation. So we can just click here on generate preview image and we see the result here. And this would be for the single image at this point of the animation. This doesn't look especially good. So what can we do now? Here we have our camera options and now there's a lot to it. But first we have our transform offset and this defines the center position offset of the transform position of the character. So the camera assumes that the character center point is the character's transform position. But with these values we can adjust this a little. If we hit on refocus, the camera will refocus according to this current settings. Okay. So and when we hit refocus, also the scene view camera will refocus, but also the main camera. And we will just record through the main camera later. So just highlight the main camera that we have the preview here. And this looks a little bit better, but not quite right. Let's see if we can set the elf a little bit more in the middle with our offset adjustments. And okay, this looks alright, a little bit more still. So, but now it is still so small. So we can go to override camera properties and we can adjust the distance to the elf here. So, but this is a perspective scene view. What if we wanted to have an orthographic view? Then we just check this one. And it is orthographic. We can still adjust a little. Okay. So, but now the angle. Maybe I want to have another angle. So now we have the possibility to choose between a lot of angles here, forward, up, down, also isometric angles. And if this isn't good enough, we can just manually set the main camera angle. I will adjust it a little here, rotating a little bit, like this. And then we can go back and set it into focus again. But I think I will go with the regular isometric angles. So I have chosen this, and it looks alright. So if the camera settings are correct, we can close them again. And generate our new preview image. And this looks better. But we have also the possibility to add an outline to the texture. And this happens simply by clicking on Add Texture Outline. Here we can set the color and the alpha threshold. The regular settings should allow for a black outline. So and if we generate our preview again, we have an outline on the character. So now, the record type, or this should be set to animator later, right now it doesn't matter. Then we have the export options. If we have set our camera angles and we have seen the preview and it looks alright, we can set our export options. Right now this image has a resolution of 100x100, we can make it a little bit smaller, 80x80. And the export mode I will set to sprite sheet. When I preview again, the resolution is worse actually, so let's try it with a higher one, 120. Okay, this looks better. Let's go for this one. So, after everything is set, we have to select our output folder, and I will store it in the streaming assets, like so. Last step is to hit on record animation, and then we have our sprite sheet ready. Oh, actually, I have forgotten one thing. We can set the frames per seconds here. So right now it will only record one image per second, but we can set it to 10 and we will get 10 images per second of animation. I will override the existing one, we don't need this anymore, and record the animation again. So let's see inside our output folder. And we can see we have the sprite sheet right here. And that was pretty easy. So we can also export this as single images. And this time we can also save the asset. We can also set the preset. So this, we have a whole number of settings. We have the camera distance to the player, the camera angle. We have some camera options, such as orthographic view or not. And we have our export options here. And we can store all this with a scriptable object. And it will get exported automatically. So just hit here, copy preset to output folder, select single images. And then I will record another animation. Okay. Let's see. Now I have single images and I have this asset file. This is our scriptable object. It has the preset suffix before the file extension. And to be picked up by Unity, I will just move this into another asset, not the streaming assets. And I will just put it here on the presets folder. Okay, well, I had an existing one. So, this is our start preset. If I make changes now here, for example, I change this up, the sprite sheet, and maybe another animation. Okay, the animation is actually not stored, but we can set other camera options, and now it looks very different. But we can restore our previous settings. So if you leave your work and you want to continue at another time with the export, but want to maintain the same settings, this is for you. And to load the camera presets, we have a field here, camera preset, and we have only this one asset we exported. And then I can set apply camera preset, and that should be it. And right now we have the same options as before. And I can generate a new preview image, and it should be the same. So that is basically it. I hope you consider the asset if it is something for you, and let me know about your feedback. Thanks.